Option we should think about. Senator Roy Blunt is a Republican from Missouri. He says it's time to simplify gasoline. So, Senator, what do you mean by that, and why do you think it's important now?
Well, Jenna, this is based on a bill that I introduced in the House right before Katrina, that allowed us to eliminate the use of these boutique fuels if there was a disruption because of a natural disaster. That happened. President Bush immediately put this law into place, and gasoline prices really weren't impacted, even though Katrina was very disruptive. This just allows the administration one more tool. If there's any disruption in supply or any disruption in the supply chain, instead of having 20 different kinds of gasoline out there, you could go for a reasonable period of time and just make gas a commodity again. That, and understanding that we need more American energy. The problem is not that there's not enough energy in the world. The problem is we don't produce nearly as much as we use, and it also would help us establish more U.S. jobs.
Well, you mentioned there being, for example, 20 different types of gasoline, and one of the reasons that we see different gasoline across this country and different prices is because different states have different standards. For example, California likes a cleaner blend of gasoline. They have so many drivers, and so that's a state issue that they put into place for their gasoline. So then it kind of leads us to a question about states' rights and what rights states have to control commerce within their state. Why do you think that the federal government should get involved in this issue?
It's largely not a state issue. It's largely a Clean Air Act issue. California is different than the other 49 states, because they did adopt apparently their own standard. But in other places, it's each city thinking early on that they had to have a blend of gas that was right just for them. Kansas City, Missouri uses a different blend of gas than St. Louis, Missouri does. And there's no real reason for just an unlimited amount of blends of gas for clean air. So what we did a few years ago was cap the numbers they could choose. And this bill would just simply allow you, in times of disruption of supply, to be sure that supply was available. If one refinery goes down, if somehow the Suez Canal is closed, it would just to give the administration another tool to make gasoline a commodity for a short period of time. We've already done this once right after Katrina. It had a big impact on short-term gas prices. This gives them another tool, but again, the bigger thing to do is to have more American energy. And remember, the administration's stated policy on energy apparently has been that it would make it so hot people don't use it. That's no energy policy. That's a policy that destroys the economy. And we're seeing what happens when there's just an uptick in the per barrel price of
right.
oil.
Right, we certainly have. It's down a little bit today, but you're absolutely right, and our viewers are feeling it as well. It's an interesting topic and one we want to continue to talk about a little bit, sir. I have to switch to another topic here because it's a big story today about the budget. And one of the things that we just learned is that the federal government had its largest monthly deficit in history last month, $223 billion. And this is a little ironic because at the same time we're getting this budget deficit, we're trying to figure out the budget for this year. And this is happening on your watch, the Republicans and Democrats. The question our viewers really have is, why is it taking so long to, one, figure out a way to fund the government, and two, why are we still getting the deficits at this level after all the talk about spending?
Well, it didn't happen on the watch of Republicans. It happened when Democrats were in charge of the House, the Senate, and the White House. We still have Democrats in charge of the Senate and the White House, and they're unwilling to even make the entry-level decision of how we get this $1.6 trillion problem under control. For the decade from 1997 to 2007, I don't think the annual deficit was as big as the monthly deficit in February. And of course, I'm going to support $61 billion in cuts, and that still puts us a trillion and a half away from the goal. If you can't make this initial decision September the 30th, in some areas, you're never going to solve this problem. And people should watch the debate this week and see if they want this problem solved and how they want it solved.
It certainly is one we're continuing to watch. Sir, we appreciate your insight today and for joining us, Senator Blunt. Thank you very much.
Thank you.